everyone, I'm Adriana, and today with the help of Leonardo we are going to work with this iPhone XS that won't turn on and it has consumption on the power Z. Today we are going to try to fix it, as over time these devices usually have problems with the motherboard. So stay close because we are going to see a good repair case. To get to the motherboard, we need to remove these two screws at the bottom and then remove the screen. We won't waste too much time with the disassembly process. We'll use fast camera because, like I said before, time is gold and should not be wasted. Finally, we've reached the motherboard, so carefully we remove it. We connect the motherboard to the power laboratory supply to check its consumption. We turn on the iPower tool and we press the power button. We will select the power laboratory supply at 0.5 amperes and then we give it 3 amperes. In the description of this video, I will leave you the link from where to buy the power laboratory supply and the iPower. These are essential tools for any technician. The good thing about this power laboratory supply is that you can select 500 mAh to look for small consumption. From all the power laboratory supplies I have, this one is the best one for mobile repairs. I'll check if I've got the purchase link and I'll put it in the description of this video. I personally like to check and try to see how it works and then use the product I'll use in the future. I've worked with Velman brand for over 60 years and right now the 3 that I have are working like in the first day. But as technology advances, you realize that you need other specific tools. To grow as a technician over the years, you'll need to invest some money in high quality tools. We can see that the motherboard has high consumption, so before separating the boards, we need to inspect them with the help of the microscope. The inspection is essential and often reveals burnt, corroded, or broken components. Since we haven't found anything, we'll separate the two motherboards. To separate it, I'll use the KC brand tool. It works great and you just need to wait for it to reach 180 Celsius degrees and you are good to go. You can also use some flux to help. The trick to separating these motherboards is not to apply too much force when you remove the top part. In this way we won't damage any pad. Now we'll go to the microscope to inspect the pads. As you can see, we haven't lost any. After reviewing the pads, we perform a visual inspection of the component. Now we'll identify which side has the short circuit. We connect the top part of the motherboard to the power laboratory supply and we press the power button. The short circuit is on the top part, so we go straight with the thermal camera. We can notice that the U3300 is heating up. On another part of the motherboard, it looks like we have a small leak. We'll keep that in mind. This is the circuit that's heating up. In such cases, I like to remove the circuit and measure the impedance of all the pads. In this way, I'll know exactly where the fault is. We use the gravity technique and we remove it quickly. After measuring the impedance of all the pads, it turns out that the main line is in short circuit. In this way, we know that the U3300 is fine. This is the capacitor that was heating up. With the help of the tweezer, we remove it and we replace it with the new one. With the help of the tester, we'll check it. The red tip to ground and with the black tip, we measure the pads. We can see that the short circuit is gone. All that's left is to clean the surface with the desoldering wick and to solder the circuit. For the reballing process, we use 180 Celsius solder paste and an inexpensive stencil. To solder it, we use 380 Celsius degrees and 40% air. You can see how the circuit automatically moves to find the exact position. To join the two motherboards, we take advantage of the old solder and we apply a good quality flux. In this way, we'll revive the old solder. Lately, I've been using this technique and so far everything is great. All you have to do is to separate the two motherboards very well. The last step is to join the two motherboards with the heater. Unlike the other one, this heater works at 220 Celsius degrees. I really like this tool for joining motherboards in general. To save time, let's use fast camera. When it reaches 220 Celsius degrees, we turn off the machine and we let the motherboard to cool down. This repair process might seem complicated, but with time it can be done without any issues. Now we'll assemble the device and we perform the checks. Finally, we can see a good charge of 2 amperes. Guys, here's Leonardo. This was today's video. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.